Alright, we got all that set up. So, Wizard of Legend is an indie game, if anybody doesn't know. And, yeah, what's up? This is Ron the Tryhard, by the way. And, really fun game. I very much enjoy it. It's kind of a little bit of a bullet hell, like, roguelite game. Kind of plays like Zelda almost, but, like, really fast paced combat. You can use all sorts of different spells and stuff. I'll just jump right in here. I already have already beaten the game twice, so I already have But I would highly recommend this game to anybody who has Steam or a Switch. Might be on other consoles as well, I haven't really looked into it. But yeah, it's got two-player offline co-op as well, so. Pretty nice. Let's go back here. There is. We're just gonna start at the beginning here so you can get an idea. Yep, I am this dude. I'm a wizard, Harry. Museum of Lenovo. Here's a complimentary airbrush dash arcana for your convenience. Now I can do the same thing this guy's doing. So yeah, you get a dash, but it has no iframes, so. Dang. I didn't even read this. Did you know that true wizards never ever take their hoods off? Never ever? Ever ever ever? Never. It's just random bystanders. We'll go through this. This is just showing all the different elements you can get. There's lightning, which is my personal favorite. Earth, air, fire, and water. And then there's a sixth element. That's the chaos element, which you only get by beating the game. You get one chaos arcana each time that you beat it. These are just kind of showing you what these are. This guy just gives me some attacks. So you have a basic attack, which doesn't, like, you know, it's just your kind of typical basic attack. You have other things like this. Pretty straightforward. Some baddies. You can use, like, a special, which, oh, I forgot. So you get a signature arcana, as you can see is that. Basically, once your meter fills up all the way, which fills up by, you know, attacking thing, you use your signature, do some massive damage. There's the dudes that, like the council members that you fight. There's a fourth one they just added recently, air dude. There's some chaos arcana. Now they're just taking me through the tutorial here. So, kind of learn to zip around and not fall into pits. How's the audio, by the way? Still testing this out for Switch. Now I got another Arcana. basically it. It's very hard, kind of as you go. And it is a roguelite, so all the levels are randomly generated. Very fun game. And I've only beaten it twice, as I said. All the hours I put in. It's basically just a tutorial, and all this stuff. You can get relics, which are, you know, bonus power-ups. You only get one at a time. And you basically, from there, you can get up to, like you see here, I start with one, but then in the actual dungeon, you can get kind of random ones as you go. So, yeah. You can get some pretty busted combos if you get the right RNG with relics, which is usually how I end up winning. So. Okay, good. Glad to see that you're okay. Welcome to your new home away from home. The wizard invited to participate in the Chaos Trials. Your accommodations and services are provided by the Magic Council. Also included is a one-time stipend of 100 Chaos Gems. You'll have to excuse the mess. We weren't expecting any guests so soon. Not to worry, we'll have everything sorted out shortly. In the meantime, let's do a round of introductions. We talk to all these people, blah blah blah. I already have all this stuff, so this is just a tutorial. These guys just tell you what they do. And you go out here. And we're in town. Oh. Yeah, so these guys are still talking. Still in the tutorial. So yeah, here's... So yep, I... just like lightning. I mean, I'm a DPS guy, so this is all just DPS. Very fast, stuns them a lot, shocks them, all that stuff. Very fun. I've kind of mixed back and forth every so often, but now I've just kind of stayed pure lightning. But you can mix and match, so like, you unlock more as you go, you buy them, or you find them in dungeons. And yeah, you get your basic attack, and you can kind of customize, so like, I can get bolt discs. Or I can do kind of more of like a melee deal where I just attack. Whoops, that's the wrong one. I have to remember that B is A and A is B now. I'm from a game using a 360 controller. So yeah, that's more of a one-on-one. But I personally like bolt rail here. I can just zap enemies and spray instead of an arc. So that's... I love that. This is my signature. Yeah, it's a pretty fun game overall. And the little relic thing that I use is the vampire glasses. Easily my favorite. They regenerate health every time that I land a critical hit on things. And my cloak here actually increases crit rates and increases crit damage, so... basically, I'm just a fast DPS, high crit, healing person. See what this guy has to offer. This guy sells cursed stuff, which is like a one-time use thing, but they're basically bound to you and it gives you some, like, you know, dangerous price for something that gives you a benefit with it. Okay, no, we're not putting any of that. Sometimes you can get lucky and they sell a thing called a crocodile heart, which reduces my HP by half, but then every time I kill something, it boosts my HP up each time, like my max HP. So you can end up getting like insane amounts of health with it. So this randomly assorts the order, so right now it's ice, then wind, then fire. And after that, if I manage to beat those three guys, I get to the boss. Usually I end up getting there, and then I die, depending on what RNG gives me. They only start you off with two Arcana, you get one signature and one regular, and then you get a dash and a basic, so... oh yeah, my dash does like an arc thing. It creates like an arc of electricity. And just like in Zelda, you break pots, you break stuff, you get money. So you could just be running through everything. Dudes are new. Update. They added a few new things, like some new arcana, they added new mobs and stuff, and then they added the wind area. Oh man, we already got some really good stuff here. Man, if only I had the money. Okay, we're gonna get relic rewards card as soon as I can afford it, because that makes everything cheaper. Shop. Afford other stuff. Yeah, you basically just have to kind of explore the dungeon and get money so you can buy more stuff. So you can kind of get a good build working. Because they have armor, and they drop the truck. These guys make it a bullet hell for you. And we special. Need to get into a room. Kill things. Nice, you can push enemies off too. But yeah, DPS, lots of zapping and electricity. Oh, the version of that. Man. Shame I don't have that much money. Starting out, I kind of want to prioritize, I mean, me personally, I like prioritizing relics over arcana, because you can get arcana from bosses, so it's like, what I need to get them. But relics, you know, they give you a bunch of extra bonuses. Sucky thing about this is my special meter wears off very fast. Oh, this is. Oh. Wave with low health when defeated, but consumes half of current health when picked up. That actually sounds really nice. I can't afford to lose half my health this early. Expend all gold at the start of each stage and heal for a fraction. Damage and stuns are increased, but movement speed is reduced. Okay, this one. Pretty nice, but that's for each first relic. Oh, that's you know what? We're gonna do this. Now I have a halo. Yeah, the downside of cursed items, I can't take them off, so I'm stuck with whatever I choose. Originally, before they patched it, they didn't used to tell you what they did. You just had to kind of learn. But it was like you were taking a gamble with each one if you didn't actually look up what they did. And that was lots of fun. Okay. We're going to get sports card. We're going to get this, because it increases my crit chance even higher. And if I'm lucky, might be able to get the Arcana Rewards or the Yuffie's Shawl. I'm gonna probably get this if I can. Quick boss and see where we go. The way that these guys work is they have a yellow aura around them indicating that they have armor, and then after their attack, they basically have a chance where they can get stunned. Armor wears off. Then once you drop a combo, they get their armor back. They're really easy early on. Significantly harder. Okay, this I can sell once I can, if I can. Otherwise I might just have to pitch it. That. Although, actually, you know what? I actually want to get this. Now this does even more. Oh, that's way better. That. I don't know if I'm actually making this game look easy. It is not easy. I'll tell you that right now. Wait till I get to stage 2 and 3. Like, that's when it starts getting tougher. I need to probably get some health though at some point. I'm not careful, I can get cornered very easily by these dudes. At the same time, they can get cornered very easily by me, so. Thank you. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, so this is the dude who buys relics. And the way that the NPCs work is that they randomly pop up just like everything else. You have to just get lucky and then these guys. I use lightning. Just big AoE spells that they can't touch you. Falcon things are actually kind of cool. Dragon Surf. Ready to go. Okay, that's 100%. I got some money. Buy that. I don't want to buy that, but that's a bit pricey. What are they offering? That. Remember what that dude does. Gold gloves are pretty nice. You know what, we'll do that. Easy, no damage. Oh, that's a cursed thing. Don't remember what that does. I think that's the... I want to say that's one that, like, does something with damage, but decreases damage or something. I don't know. I'm not gonna bother. Cursed items are usually bad. Like, only a couple cursed items I'll actually take, like that halo. Pretty good run so far. Too late to be getting cold feet. I'm about to freeze you in your tracks. These guys make really bad puns. They're elements. certainly know how to stay cool. Ta-ta for now and stay frosty. I do not approve of these puns, but I do like puns. They're giving me more lightning. All the DPS. Is my mic picking up the game? That's the only thing I kind of was worried about. Is my mic feedbacking, you know, the audio when it gets loud? I do have this mic set up right next to my TV. And I couldn't find a way that I could use headphones. I have to research that more. Those are spikes. Those are traps. Wow, that's mean. We're still new to the wind area. This is like my third time going to it so far. Music's really badass though. First of all, the music in this game is pretty good. You guys are dropping so much health. This normally doesn't happen. Did I just go all lightning? Whatever the boss gives me. Work for me. Reduced cooldowns. Oh, that's a new one. Reduced pressure. That's pretty good. Garbage attacks. Okay. Damn it! This attack too fast. It's my job. Oh shit, I see that guy right there. Ugh! Oh, got whirlwinds. Oh no, I'm slowed. Another thing with walls. They're not walls, they're the wind. When people do is they slow you down. Break these? No. Okay. actually go back and take that health now. That's a cool thing, is they stay on the ground until you use them. Shoot. That's what I'm talking about, you gotta be careful dodging. Not as easy as it looks. Yes. This is the same thing. Oh, well, this is defeating. Oh, okay. This is the one I want. Never mind. Okay, you know what? We're doing this. I start at 250 health, but it's totally worth it because every time I kill something, I get more health back. There's, like, it stacks with other health gaining things too, so. Actually, this thing. That'll help. Pick me from projectiles. Good. There we go. It's actually my first run using this, that thing that creates, like, the circle and shoots a bunch of lightning between it. I was using, like, a water Kamehameha blast before. That was pretty cool, but I like this one way better. Lets me just continue some combo and stunlock thing. Lightning. I'm gonna get more lightning stuff though. I wanna try to get a shock agent. This totem thing boosts my lightning damage. Oh, we got the pinata this time? Alright. So this guy only dies if you kill him with one consecutive combo. So, we gotta play this raid. There we go. Easy peasy. Oh, that's cool. I got meteor now. Thank you. I have a problem with getting Arcana later on, is I forget I even have them. Actually do get them. Pretty good synergy what I got going right now. These spells they gave me. Usually though, from my experience, if a run starts out really good, it ends really bad. Like, there's the runs that start out bad and end good, and then there's the ones that start good and end bad. It's usually not the other way. It's usually nothing in between that. Things. What? We're gonna take this one. Extra use for my dash arcana, hell yeah. Increase my defense, so I'm tankier. And we're not gonna. Let's go ahead, fight the boss, and then I'll heal afterwards. This build is just too good right now. I didn't need to spend that money on that potion. Be a shame for you to come this far and choke under pressure. Throw caution to the wind and give it your all. I shall take this move. I'm still kind of learning how to deal with this guy. A big chunk out of my health. This one, it's way better. This is proving to honestly be like one of the best runs I've had so far. It can easily turn in this level. I need to turn those notifications off. Whoops. First time actually streaming Swit. Not used to turning that kind of stuff. This is mostly just a test stream. Try to stream on Switch and just wanted to see how it ends up. again. Get double damage, do some cooldown. I already got like the best one. Seems that my health is already above max. Okay, this is what I was looking for. This thing is just a little sprite that follows me around, and it poisons things. The poison is actually pretty busted. Rise. That's all I need to do is this one right here. I do not want to get stuck in the corner against those guys. Cool. Let's see if I can make it to the boss really quick. Yes. Promise you, this game is usually not this easy, not this forgiving. For some reason right now, because I'm streaming, it is. RNG has blessed me on this day. I was expecting this run to take a lot longer, too. stronger. Not a good situation. Commit blob genocide. Already up to 750 health. I think it caps at 800. Still a crap ton of health. It's really good to get this thing early on. Provided that, you know, you're good enough to not die. But it kind of pays for itself after, like, one or two rounds. Not as good in two-player, though, because it only works on things that you kill, by knowledge. Like, if your teammate kills things, then I'll get a bonus. Ah, this guy. Makes me trade all of my gold in for crystals. Which, honestly, I'm not really spending my money here. But that is tempting. This one is really good. You drop something pretty cool. What are we gonna get rid of? No, I might as well get rid of this. This increases damage for every enemy defeated. I maxed out on my relics. I'm already almost done with this. I'm gonna beat this in under an hour. Wonder what the speedrun time is for this game. Probably like 30 minutes or something stupid like that. I'm sure there's probably some crazy exploits. Okay, whoops. I did not mean to trigger that. Into my dash. Whoops, I accidentally... She's over there. No, I hate this freaking one. I'm gonna just die to that. Whoops. Do that right. Okay. So, that wasn't the best. I might actually die from that. I don't want to use this one. On this next dude, this one's gonna be more useful. Okay, don't try that. Alright, so this is where I die. Especially because I don't have much health. Congratulations on getting to this point, but no wizard has ever passed me. The end of the line for you as well. Now, let us begin the final challenge. Bone zone now. Seems I've underestimated you. Let's begin a true duel between wizards. And now it gets hard. Not like this. Gosh. So close. Nope. That's it. Oh wait, I'm still alive. I got the second win. Forgot about that. Oh, nope, I'm dead again. Yep, I'm dead. I just dodged into that. Damn it. Saw how close I was there. Holy crap. So yeah. As I said, I only beat that guy twice. That was like two hits away from beating him then. But I freaking joked it. As I usually do. Oh. Yeah. Let's see, that's been about an hour. I think that kind of gives a rough idea of the game. I don't think I'm gonna get a run that good again. So. Got a ton of these crystals. Spend all this on stuff. I'm mostly just trying to complete out stuff because I kind of found a winning thing already. Buy it all. Oh. That's not everything, surely. I think that's just... I think you can only buy so much each time. Go ahead and buy all these. I haven't really been buying relics. I've been buying Arcana. There we go. Unlock all the things. So yeah, that's... Yeah, well, like I was telling you, Feora, it's not the easiest game, but after you get used to it, I think you would get decent at it. It just takes a lot of grinding. I mean, like all roguelites, it's a game that you start out really slow and you kind of die and die. Like, that's how I started the game, is I died, like, you know, before I got to the first boss. And then as you get better, you kind of just start killing it. Like, I don't know how many... I'm not sure if it shows how many hours I put into this game. I think it does. Maybe? There might be like a record thing that I can pull up here. Whoops. I mean to do that. There we go. Right here? No? I have no idea. There's... Well, in any case, I've probably put at least like 50 hours into this, if not lots more. I wonder if the Switch tells me what my playtime is on that. No, I don't think so. Oh well. Anyway, that's Wizard of Legend, so hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you want to see more of it, just let me know, because I might stream it down the road, but we'll see. I think I was just doing this kind of as a one-off, just to kind of show it off, raise more awareness for the game, because it is a really awesome indie game. I would highly recommend it to anybody who, you know, makes this kind of thing. Yeah, it's just one of those kind of feel-good power trip games after you get so much stuff, but until then, it's a real hard grind. So yeah, that's that game. I'm gonna shift gears here, take a break in between here. And I will be back with other game, kind of going more casual since it's late. And I wanna do something chill. I'm gonna play Baba Is You, another indie game, I've heard of that. Pretty fun puzzle game. So let me end this here. Thanks everybody for watching. If you like this, be sure to like and comment, subscribe, let me know. I'm pushing out more content, kind of branching out a little more from my fighting game stuff, what I usually do. So if it's not your thing, that's cool, but I just kind of want to do more stuff, and finally got a capture card, so I can finally do that. All right, see you guys later.